Morella Solidoro was born on the 13th of July 1964 in Torisano, into a modest farming family. The third of five children, she lived her childhood serenely, guided and supported by the love of her parents, especially her mother, and brought up in a Christian manner by them and her godparents, who were always close to her. When she was only 9 years old, she began her slow martyrdom as a young sick girl. At the hospital in Brindisi, the doctors were able to diagnose, by means of a CT scan of the skull, an expansive process affecting the inner and middle walls of the third ventricle. Following this report, she was transferred to the Vito Fazzi Hospital in Lecce, where surgery was performed on the 28th of September 1979. A frontotemporal craniotomy was performed, with exploration of the endocranial area and biopsy of a large neoformation located in the optic chiasmatic region. Histological examination revealed a congenital tumor. The operation was carried out with the hope of a complete removal of the mass, but it proved impossible to carry out, given the extent of the mass and its delicate location, so the operation was only exploratory and diagnostic. In the meantime, Mirella's condition worsened and, soon after the operation, she lost her sight and slipped into a coma. The doctors told her she only had a few months to live. Here is her testimony. "My name is Solidoro Mirella, I am 18 years old, but I look 9. 3 years ago I had a brain surgery that ruined my eyesight. Now I am always in bed and I live and lay my faith in God, which has become the only reason of my life. When I was 9 years old, God entrusted me with a special mission, that of suffering and pain. Suffering increased day by day, and my parents tried to find a remedy for all the suffering. But no one understood me. I tried to find consolation in God, who became for me my faithful father, my consoler, who gave me the strength to face my little duties, school, and studies. At the age of 14, on the 28th of September 1979, I underwent a surgery that left me blind. But it was in that darkness that I began to see. It was not the light of the world but the light of God. That was for me the decisive calling to the cross. I woke up on the 2nd of May 1982, feeling like a newborn child. God helped me to appreciate and esteem the cross, and I understood that this was the most beautiful gift for me. I accepted the pain and loved it so much that I longed for it. I understood that the Lord needed souls. I understood that the Lord needed souls willing to sacrifice themselves for the salvation of humanity. Many were the suffering people who sought her out or called her on the phone for comfort, advice and the support of her prayer. She treated everyone with gentleness and instilled serenity, despite her unspeakable sufferings. In her hands she constantly wove the rosary. She prayed day and night, because her almost continuous insomnia gave her the possibility to intercede for everyone. In 1998, due to intense pain, she was forced to go to San Giovanni Rotondo, to the Casa Salvo della Sofferenza Hospital. The doctors were powerless. She went to Tricase Hospital on the 27th of September 1999. She was very sick. Conscious, but hardly responding. 4 days later she went into an irreversible coma, and on the morning of October 4, 1999 she passed away so peacefully, like a little bird, said the doctor who was assisting her. We are left with her evangelical testament. Live to give, die to receive. And the certainty that, from heaven, Mirella still prays and intercedes for everyone. The servant of God rests in the parish church Santi Martiri G. Battista M. Already in Torisano,